Let's do this. Hello, boys and girls. Today we're going to be learning about Peter Freuchen, who was the most interesting man in the world, or at the very least, the most interesting Viking. He was a Dane who, among the many accomplishments of his life, explored Greenland, killed a polar bear that he ended up wearing as a coat, lost a leg, wrote over 30 books, a screenplay, fought Nazi propaganda, escaped from a Nazi internment camp, and also dug his way out of an ice cave using his own frozen feces. All of these things we will touch on throughout this video, but let's start at the beginning of his life. What better place to start? So he was born February 20th, 1886, to a reasonably middle-class family in Denmark. His father was a businessman, and his father wanted him to pursue a further higher education, which Peter did, actually. He went to the University of Copenhagen when he was a young man to study medicine. Turns out, young Freuchen did not actually care about university, and so he ended up in 1906 joining a expedition known as the Denmark Expedition to go and explore the ironically named island of Greenland. The purpose of this expedition was twofold. First, it was an anthropological mission to rediscover the local Inuit population of Greenland, which hadn't been seen for almost 80 years. The last time it had been seen was in 1823 by an Arctic explorer by the name of Douglas Clavering. Second reason was to attempt to finish mapping the island, the coastline of the island. They had traveled as far north as they had previously, and they hadn't finished mapping out the entirety of it, because the task was just incredibly difficult to do, given the incredibly harsh climate that Greenland has, especially the further north you go. But despite that, Freuchen et al. Ended up trekking over 4,039 miles in total as they mapped the various northern coasts of Greenland. He lost a lot of his companions in the process, but they actually did make it up all the way up around. And after that, Freuchen had caught the bug. After returning to Denmark in 1908, he ended up setting out for Greenland again, and he ended up forming the Thule Trading Station in Cape York, Greenland, which actually exists to this day. And fun fact, my dad actually, during his time on an American icebreaker, actually visited Thule as a young man. But anyways, from 1910 to 1924, he ended up heading a number of expeditions known as the Thule Expeditions, often with his friend and fellow explorer, Knud Rasmussen. The first Thule expedition was north to Peary Land, which is in northern Greenland, almost the very tip north of Greenland. It was a 620-mile journey, and they were doing it to prove or disprove Robert Peary's claim of a strait separating Peary Land, which is actually a peninsula, from the rest of Greenland. Turns out it doesn't exist, but nevertheless, this journey was lauded by Clements Markham, who was the president of the Royal Geographic Society in England, as, quote, the finest ever performed by dogs. So that was quite a spectacular journey to be able to do this. During his time in Greenland, Peter Freuchen actually made contact with the Inuit people that were still living in Greenland, and he ended up living with them for a time. And he learned their language and their culture, how they were living off the land to survive the harsh conditions of this Arctic wilderness. And the latter of these skills, he actually resulted in this 6'7" Dane killing a polar bear, which he skinned and wore as a coat, which just made his large frame even more imposing. He was just this monster of a man, especially considering the time. At the time, the Danes were considered some of the tallest people in the world. That portion of the population was considered very tall, but even then, the average height was about 5'10". If I remember correctly, and he was 6'7". Even today, the average height is about 6 foot. So even by today's standards, he was insanely tall, but you can see pictures of him towering over people. The man was just enormous. On another of Freuchen's missions, he found himself caught in a blizzard. And while he hunkered down to avoid the harsh weather, he was quickly covered with snow, and his breath and body heat ended up melting some of the snow around him while he was buried, which turned the snow into this kind of icy cave. And locked him inside of it. And at the time he was seeking shelter, he didn't have any of his usual daggers or spears or any of those things with him. And so he was kind of trapped inside of this. But Freuchen refused to die here, and he, according to his book Vagrant Viking, he used his own frozen feces to form a sort of dagger, and that's what he used to dig himself out of this cave, and he ended up making it, surviving to get back to his camp. In 1911, Freuchen married an Inuit woman called Navarana, who would accompany Freuchen on many of his expeditions, and with her he ended up having two children, whose names I'm not going to attempt to pronounce, but they're here. They ended up being married for a fairly long time. In fact, she traveled with him back to Denmark and ended up exploring his homeland with him, and was very fascinated with it, but was also kind of disturbed by the fact that none of these women in Denmark knew how to hunt, because all they had to do was go down to the shop to be able to buy their groceries and their food needs. But she did find ballet endlessly fascinating. But both Freuchen and his friend Rasmussen used their time both in Thule and in Denmark to educate the general public on their numerous expeditions, as well as about the Inuit culture. Sadly, though, Navarana, Freuchen's wife, died of the Spanish flu in 1921, and because she wasn't baptized, the church in Upernavik, in Greenland, refused to bury her in their church graveyard. They refused to be a part of that entire ceremony, so Freuchen buried her himself. And actually, kind of a sweet thing, in 1933, Knud Rasmussen, he would honorifically use the name Navarana for the lead role in his film The Wedding of Paolo. In 1924, Freuchen went back to Denmark, where he met his second wife, Magna Vanglardsen, and he also joined the Social Democrat Party, for whom he wrote several articles in their newspaper, Politiken. In 1926, he then went on another Arctic expedition, and it was on this mission that he had gone out from camp, and on his return came to realize that his toes had become gangrenous and his left leg was completely frostbitten. But Freuchen being Freuchen, no muss, no fuss, he used a pair of shears and a hammer to amputate his own toes, sans anesthesia, and then he had a doctor in the Hudson Bay replace his leg with a wooden peg. He then moved back to Denmark, where he became the editor-in-chief for the magazine Ude og Hem, which means out of home, and it was owned by Magda's family. He did this job from 1926 to 1932, and in 1932, he was hired by Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer to return to Greenland to assist filming the movie adaptation of his book, Eskimo. And Freuchen, at 6'7", with a bushy beard and a peg leg, played the villain in his own movie. In the late 1930s, Freuchen continued his world travels, visiting both South Africa and, at the request of the Russian government, Siberia, the latter of which he recorded in his book, Siberian Events, which was published in 1939. As we all know, Germany was coming up with some interesting ideas around this time, and Peter Freuchen didn't have any time for discrimination. He was known for approaching people, spouting anti-Semitic comments in all of his 6'7" peg-legged glory, and announced that he was Jewish, a method I can only imagine had spectacular results. He was, in fact, so outspoken about his anti-Nazi views that his books were banned in Germany, and he was labeled as a Yiddisher Schweinhund, which is Russian or German for Jewish bastard, by the Nazis, which I'm sure was a title he wore with pride. During the Second World War, Freuchen actually joined the Danish underground and used his island Enehohe, I'm probably saying most of these things wrong, so don't at me, which was on the Nakskov Fjord in Denmark, for Jewish refugees. He actually brought them to his private island and was using it to kind of funnel Jewish refugees out of the Nazi-occupied areas. He was so influential, actually, that the Nazis that were occupying Denmark at the time ordered his capture and, after placing him in a camp, sentenced him to death, which clearly they were unaware of the type of man they had in custody, because unsurprisingly, the peg-legged Viking escaped his confines by climbing over a barbed wire fence, after which he was smuggled by some of his friends to Sweden in a fishing boat. In 1944, his marriage to Magda ended up dissolving, and he moved to New York City. And in 1945, he married a Danish Jewish fashion illustrator named Dagmar Cohn. And he spent much of his later life splitting his time between New York City and his house in Connecticut. He wrote a lot of books about his adventures, assisted a variety of Hollywood studios as an advisor on all things Arctic, and became the fifth person to win the jackpot on the game show, The $64,000 Question. You can actually see a clip of this in the playlist that I have called This Week's Cool Stories. I'll put a clip in there. And he also continued to travel. In fact, it was while visiting Elmendorf Air Base in Anchorage, Alaska, that on September 2nd, 1957, the great Peter Freuchen suffered a heart attack while moving heavy baggage up a loading ramp. His ashes were spread over Thule, Greenland, where his life as an adventuring legend began. To sum up this great man's accomplishments, he mapped huge portions of Greenland and paved the way for further exploration of that great island, dug his way out of an ice cave using his own frozen feces, lost his leg to frostbite and his toes to gangrene. He wrote over 30 books, several movies, including the Oscar-winning Eskimo, thwarted Nazis by assisting Jewish refugees, and escaped their custody after he was sentenced to die, just so that he could then live out his life in the U.S. as Hollywood royalty. It's just crazy. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed that brief history of the great life of Peter Freuchen. I guess I'll see you next time. Peace. He was captured by... Start at the beginning. Why not start at the beginning of his life and work your way from there? Why start it? Doesn't matter. Let's try this again. In 1924, where he met his second wife, Magna Vang Lauridsen. He cut off his own gangrenous toes. He also joined the Social Democratic Party. Social Democrat Party. That's it. Not Democratic. Social Democrat Party. Magna Vang Lauridsen. At this part. Point. This point. Where he met his second wife, Magna Vang Lauridsen. Where he became the editor-in-chief for the magazine Ude Aghem. Just come shoot me.